When Michael showed me this microphone, I didn't believe him when he said that it still worked. So I ran upstairs and got my laptop and my Focusrite. Please ignore the sound in the background. And plugged it in. And look, still works. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3.
So we're in the Shure archives, and you might hear some noise in the background because we're next to the machining room. And this is a poor Super 55 that was run over by a Chevy Tahoe SUV. It was sent to Shure by a customer in 2014. It had been given to him by his wife as an anniversary present, and he had used it for every gig. One night they were packing up late at night, and for some dumb reason, he said, he stuck it into the windshield well of his truck. He's driving home, he gets off the expressway, and he sees something slide off the hood of his truck and go onto the road. He pulls over and he sees it's his beloved Super 55. He gets out of his truck to go back and get it, just as a Chevy Tahoe runs over and crushes it. As you can see, it's crushed condition. Next day, he plugs it in and it works perfectly. So he sends us a note of thanks, and we send, hey, we'd like to give you a brand new one in exchange for this. And I asked him the question, have you told your wife? And he said, I haven't had the courage yet. I said, don't, she'll never have to know. So we sent him a brand new Super 55, and we got this crushed one. We also ran, in exchange for it, we ran the tests on it. Curves are pretty good, and just shows you that you just can't damage or defeat a Shure no matter what you do with it. So now I'm going to stop talking and turn it around so you can see the sides and the back. And now let's just shake it a little bit. So, do we make tough things? Yeah, I think we do. And this is a perfect example of it.
Thank you very much for showing me that.
You're welcome.